Good morning, students. We are going to continue chapter 1, A Letter to God. We have read that Lencho was depressed as his crops were destroyed by the hail storm. But he had faith in God and he had written a letter to God for asking money. Now see what happened. The following Sunday, Lencho came a little earlier than usual to ask if there was a letter for him. It was the postman himself who handed a letter to him. While the postmaster, experiencing the contentment of a man who has performed a good deed, looked on from his office. When Lencho reached to the post office next Sunday, the postman handed him the letter and the postmaster wanted to see facial expression of Lencho because the postmaster was satisfied as he had helped a man. Lencho showed not slightest surprise on seeing the money. Such was his confidence. But he became angry when he counted the money. God could not have made a mistake, nor could he have denied Lencho what he had requested. Lencho thought that God must have sent him 100 pesos. So when he saw 70 pesos, he found that the money was less. Then he became angry and he thought that God could not deny him. Immediately, Lencho went up to the window to ask for paper and ink. On the public writing table, he started to write with much wrinkling of his brow, caused by the effort he had to make to express his ideas. When he finished, he went to the window to buy a stamp, which he licked and then affixed to the envelope with a blow of his fist. The moment the letter fell into the mailbox, the postmaster went to open it. It said, "God, of the money that I asked for, only 70 pesos reached me. Send me the rest, since I need it very much. But don't send it me through the mail because the post office employees are a bunch of crooks, Lencho." The postmaster was excited. So when the letter was dropped by Lencho, the postmaster went himself to bring the letter. And when he opened the letter, he saw Lencho's complaint. He had written to God not to send money through the post office because the post office employees were a bunch of cunning persons, Lencho. Now you can imagine the experience of postmaster. Now see the questions. Was Lencho surprised to find a letter for him with money in it? Question number 2. What made him angry? The other questions are, who does Lencho have complete faith in? Which sentences in the story tell you this? Next question, why does the postmaster send money to Lencho? Why does he sign the letter God? Did Lencho try to find out who had sent the money to him? Why not? Why does Lencho think has taken the rest of the money? What is the irony in the situation? Remember that the irony of a situation is an unexpected aspect of it. An ironic situation is strange or amusing because it is the opposite of what is expected. You will write the answer of the questions. After opening the school, I will check it. And besides it, kindly go through the basic chapters of the grammar as kind of sentence, tense, etc. Revise it and we will start new chapter in new class. In next class. Thank you. Have a nice day.